Thank you, Chair. How many times have we been here discussing illegal eavesdropping, spying on our citizens, spying on politicians, spying on journalists, harassing of whistleblowers? Do we need, you know, can we repeat all the hashtags? NSA, PRISM, Belgacom, Gemalto? Mr. Vos, would you just be just as complacent if we weren't talking about the American secret services here, but the Chinese secret services? Would you then say, oh, hey, well, you know, hey, that's what secret services do. You know, they spy on people. Get over it. Well, we happen to have rules on this continent. Who is going to protect the rights of our citizens? Who is going to protect the privacy of our citizens, Mr. Vos? Clearly, the EPP does not care. Not about privacy, not about the rule of law, not about international law. So citizens don't have to expect any protection from your side. I understand that the European Commission is saying it's the sole competence of the member states and there's not a whole lot we can do. Oh, incidentally, I note that the Council, again, is absent, because if there's any institution that doesn't give, well, I was going to use an unparliamentary term, that doesn't care very much about citizens' rights, it is the Council. But somebody needs to do it. And I refuse to accept that all of this is legal and acceptable. When are we finally going to get some answers? Because if this is what friendly nations do to us, then I wonder what not friendly nations are going to do to us. Now, Mr. Vos said, we have no proof. No, of course we have no proof. They're called secret service for a reason, because what they do is secret. So that is why we have oversight, Mr. Vos, who isn't listening. We need oversight, urgently. We need to have European rules that apply to the cross-border activities of secret services, because we must stand up for the right of our citizens. Thank you.